So here we are on the steel conduit job. Just do a quick video just to progress how, show the progress how we're getting on. We've got the sockets there. Comes through there. And so that's going to be a lighting point. There'll be another lighting point there. Another lighting point there. That then will go off into the cupboard. The sockets there. The way that I fixed the majority of the conduit on is through these plasterboard fixings. Unfortunately, I haven't got a laser level with me. That would make it so, so much easier. I need to get a new laser level. But that's just the progress so far. So, carrying on with the conduit. Back through to here. I'm going to have a piece coming off there and then going down to a light switch and maybe a socket below it. And that's what I think I've already shown you before. Now we're just doing this corner in here. It's really quite awkward. It's a bit of trial and error on this one. So we've held it up. So we've just literally held a piece up there. We're cutting that bit now. And again, we'll have a running couple on that one there. Got Dave here, just doing the threading on the conduit. That's the bit, this bit here should fit nicely just in this section here. Obviously just put a thread on there. Just show us, Dave, quickly.
Sorry.
How we did the deburred inside. So we use the cone drill. Ran it through like that, and then that just, obviously you're not supposed to use your fingers really, but there's no burrs on there, so that looks okay. Again, we haven't threaded the full section in there. We're just doing it just until we've only threaded, that's about 10 millimeters or so. We'll probably put another 3 or 4 mil thread on that so it goes in nicely. We're just doing it at the moment just so we can hold it up, get it in, bring it down again, re-thread it all the way, and it should be okay. So we've bending a 90 now. Dave's doing that. That's going to be going up into that far corner, feeding down to a light switch. So it's hard to, when you're bending 90 degree, to know exactly how far to come. So it's a bit of a trial and error sometimes. So I'm just standing to the side of it. That's still a bit more than 90 degrees, I'd say. So just bend it down a bit more. Okay, tiny bit more. And yeah, hold it there. I think that should be okay. So if you take it out, Dave.
Yep.
And that bit's going to go, it's going to feed from here. So we've done a running coupler across down to the switch, and then below that will be a socket. Now, one of the things that you can see is that we had a bit of a problem putting this piece on. It was actually really awkward. I don't know why, but it was. And you see that we have scuffed a little bit of the area doing it. So one of the tricks is when you're doing this, especially in a factory or something, you can get away with it, but when you're in someone's house like this, you've got to be really careful to be as neat as you can and not to scuff the ceiling, because we're going to have to get that bit sorted out again. But I think we've done a pretty good job on this of not scuffing it too much, and we've got the last piece now all ready to go in. I'm just getting the fixings on the wall. Again, another running coupler there to go to fix the piece in there, and then that's actually them bits done.
Interesting, Liz. It's just shy.
Yeah, so again, this isn't perfect because there's a bit of wire there that it's hard, but you can see that's slightly more than 90 degrees still. So if you go down another inch or so, that'll probably be enough. Okay.